Hello everyone and welcome back to another Star Wars figure review. Today I'm going to be going over the Vintage Collection Grand Moff Tarkin. Now this is the very first I have in my entire collection, surprisingly. And he's not completely new, but I'm not going to get into details. However, let's go ahead and take a look at the detailing. I mean, I think they captured his likeness almost perfectly, especially the head sculpt. It's not dead accurate, but it's pretty darn close with his cheekbones and everything. The hair has brown highlights in it from the gray. His hair wasn't completely gray in the movie if you look closely. Then you have the little rank badge. One other thing I found cool was, if you look at his hands, you can tell that he's really old. Not just from the head sculpt, but yes, his hands. Hasbro just captured his aging beautifully, I think. Join the Empire. I couldn't resist that. Accessories he came with were this little blaster pistol. We've seen this one countless times before, and surprisingly it fits in his hands well. Or this one at least, I haven't tried the other one. And then one very unique accessory, and I thought this one was just awesome to add, the little mouse droid. Why they added it, I don't know, but I'm glad they did. Underneath it is hollow. And the wheels do spin a little bit, but not much. Just still, perfect for dioramas. The lower part of his uniform is made of soft goods, which is also good. I mean, can't go wrong with soft goods. Almost. Anyways, the articulation for him is excellent. He has a ball jointed neck, ball hinged shoulders, ball-hinged elbows, swivel wrists, swivel waist, swivel hips, ball-hinged knees, and ball-hinged ankles. So you can get him in a variety of poses. Another one I like to do is this one. He's pretty famous for doing that, especially with a lot of the other officers as well. And here we have the packaging. Great image of him up right there. Grand Moff Tarkin. Little dust and stuff on there. Plus you can do see that the peg thing isn't punched out. I got this off Amazon, so thank you Amazon.com. More figures you can buy, and especially the newer wave. I will be reviewing Starkiller next, so stay tuned for that. About a week or so. So guys, what do you think? 5 out of 5, 4 out of 5, 3 out of 5, 2 out of 5, 1 out of 5, or just complete 0? You be the judge and jury of this figure's fate. My own personal opinion, 5 out of 5. I mean, I think they did a spectacular job on this guy. And plus, Grand Moff Tarkin is one of my favorite characters, so. Only didn't see him after A New Hope, but still. He did. Peter Cushing, who played Grand Moff Tarkin, did a great job as him. Well, that's all the time I have for this Star Wars figure review, guys. Until next time. Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.